We are talking bridge inspections with the DJI Mavic 2 Enterprise Advanced and the DJI Matrice 300 RTK with its H20T. Don't go anywhere. Hey everybody, David here from Aerial Influence. Thank you for stopping by. Today we wanted to talk a little bit about bridge inspections with the DJI Mavic 2 Enterprise Advanced and the DJI Matrice 300 RTK with the H20T. So over the past year, we've been working with Alfred Benesch & Company, that is a professional services firm. They do a lot of engineering work, a lot of inspection work. So they contacted us to do a bridge inspection demonstration with both of these drones. They've got a Matrice, but they've got the H20 without the thermal. So that is, the thermal is the H20T. The non-thermal with just the zoom lens, and you're getting that laser rangefinder and a wide lens as well, but you're not getting the thermal on it. That one is just called the H20. They bought that quite a while ago. They were impressed with it, but now they're looking at thermal. They want to see if they should upgrade to the H20T, use it as thermal, or they could even go a little cheaper and get a Mavic 2, and that's going to be cheaper with that high resolution thermal than the H20T gimbal itself before you add up all the drone stuff as well. So they've got a decision to make. So they called us out to Highland Park, wanted us to do a little bit of a demonstration on a bridge there. So we were obviously able to get both drones up above the bridge and take a look and see if there were any abnormalities. And they were able to see a difference on the bridge. Some areas are a little cooler than other areas. So that gives them the idea that there might be some sort of issue with the portion of the cement that is a little bit cooler or hotter. And that was very useful information to them. But then the challenging part, we had to take these drones underneath the bridge. I took the Mavic under there. We were able to get right up in there with the thermal and really get a good look as to what's going on with the pillars, what's going on with the overall structure of that bridge, to make sure that it's doing well. And then the super challenging part, so the Mavic was one thing, that was not that difficult because it is pretty heavily wooded, but the drone is pretty small. Michael flew the Matrice down there. That is not something that I would do. He's very brave, but he flew the Matrice 300 RTK with the H20T underneath that bridge as well. He was able to navigate through the trees, did a great job. He's a great pilot. So if you pay a little extra, it's not that expensive, a couple hundred dollars, you can get the top mount for the Matrice 300 RTK. And that's really, really useful when you're doing bridge inspections. Michael was able to get under that bridge. He was able to look straight up. So that's really important. And that's something that the DJI Mavic 2 Enterprise Advanced can't do. It cannot look straight up. It does have a little bit of a tilt where it's able to look up a little bit, but it cannot look straight up. That is something that the Matrice 300 RTK can do if you get that top mount. And again, Michael, very skilled pilot, was able to get right in there and give Benesch exactly what they were looking for. Both of these have thermal. Both of these have their pluses and negative. The pluses of the Mavic, obviously it has high resolution thermal and it's very, very compact, easy to throw in the back of a car. The Matrice 300 RTK with the H20T is very durable. It is all weather mostly, I mean, to an extent. You're able to fly in a little bit of rain, a little bit of snow, but it is very durable, very, very stable in high winds as well. And with the H20T gimbal, you're not only getting that high resolution thermal that you get on the Mavic 2 Enterprise Advanced, but you're also getting a huge optical zoom range. You're getting a zoom range of 200 times total once you get past 23 times. So it's 23 times optical zoom, 200 times digital zoom. So once you get past 23 times, it's gonna start to digitize just a little bit, but really does have an amazing zoom range. The negative of it is that it's big. Hard to lug around, it's got a big case, you gotta put the legs on, you gotta straighten the arms out and make sure those are locked. So there's a lot that goes into flying that drone, but it's another really, really good one for inspection. So as we know right now, engineering and structural design is a huge thing. We all saw that with the building collapse in Miami. We see that with bridges all the time, bridges that just suddenly go out as people are driving across them. So this is a real issue that affects public safety in general. And we know drones are gonna be a big part of the future and a big part of fixing this problem. So we appreciate you stopping by. We just like to give you guys sort of some examples of what we're doing with our customers, different use cases for the drones. So we hope you enjoyed this. If you did, hit like and subscribe, and we will see you next time.